Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, as usual with a new Shopify how-to video. And in today's video, I will teach you guys how you can add a pop-up to your Shopify store without using any app. Yes, you won't be using any app, any paid nor free app. We'll be adding a pop-up using custom code. As you can see the pop-up, this is the pop-up. That's how the pop-up looks like, and it will show up on load. We can add the time delay on this pop-up. We can have feature to add multiple entrance animation in this pop-up. And if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe and comment. So without further ado, let's get into the back end of our Shopify store. Okay guys, so that's the freshly installed Dawn theme. And that's the back end of Shopify store. I'm already logged in. As you can see, I have recently added this Dawn theme and its latest version, which is 7.0.1. And if I refresh, there's no pop-up at the moment showing up. Okay, now in order to add the pop-up, we will go and edit the code. Click on these three small dots and click on edit code. Before editing the code, please make sure to have a duplicate. In case you add a wrong code or add the code on the wrong line numbers, you can easily revert your theme back to its original state. Okay. Now click on edit code, and first we will be adding our JS code in global.js. So that's the file where we will be adding our JavaScript code for the newsletter pop-up. Scroll down to the bottom, and now I'm gonna paste the code. So that's the JavaScript code, jQuery code, which we'll be adding to make sure that our pop-up runs smoothly. And in this final line, after adding the JS code, this line is for if you want your pop-up to show only once per user, you will mention it true. For now, I'm adding it as false because I want you to show you guys how the pop-up will look like. So if you make it false, the pop-up will keep loading again and again. I'm going to discuss further features of that jQuery pop-up in a while after adding that into a theme. Okay, now after adding the JS code, hit save. After saving the global.js file, navigate to your theme.liquid and include the jQuery CDN. In order to do that, I'll just search for jQuery CDN, and in there you will find releases.jquery.com, from where you can add jQuery. Okay, let's click on minified version, and I'll just copy this and paste it, add it below head in your theme.liquid file. Okay, now hit save. After adding theme.liquid jQuery including code, let's add in some CSS code. Now navigate to base.css file. And in that file, we will be adding our CSS code for the pop-up. So that's the CSS code. Just copy the complete code and paste it on the bottom of your CSS file. There we go. Now click on save. And now lastly, we'll add pop-up code in our theme.liquid file. So now I'll be adding this code in our theme.liquid file. We can add this code below head on top of our file. So I'll just add below the jQuery code, which we already added. Now paste the code. Again, don't worry about the codes. You will find all of the codes in YouTube video description. So I'll add a blog post link where I'll add further instructions on which line number you need to copy and paste the code to. Okay, now hit save. And after saving the file, let's go to our theme and hit refresh. Here you go. Our pop-up is showing up now. Let's hit refresh again. And here you go. Pop-up is showing up. Now, if you go to the JS code, global.js, I have these triggers. Attent page triggers means that user will have to scroll down to the bottom and scroll back up in order to view the pop-up. And onload is already implemented. So if anyone comes in to your website, it will show this pop-up. And on idle means that it will take some time to load when the pop-up shows. It will have to scroll down to a certain level. And we have like several animations as well. We can display the pop-up in fade-in animation. We can display the pop-up in fly-in right, fly-in left, and fly-in up animation. So that's the defined animation. So what we're gonna do, currently it's showing up as fade. Now I'm gonna show you guys how it will look when I copy the fly in down value and hit paste this, copy this value and paste it under inverted commas of animation, just like I did, and hit refresh. Sorry, hit save and then go back to home page and refresh. Okay, after saving the JS file, hit refresh and you will see that animation is updated. As you can see, it's coming from the down. Similarly, we can try other animation if you want. Let's try one more, which is fly in right. Hit save and then go back to home page and hit refresh. As you saw that the pop-up window came from the right. Okay, we have few other settings, like we can add delay. Currently it's 100 ms. We can increase it to be 500 ms or whatever you want, whatever is suitable for you. I already told you guys about the user session thing. So if you want to appear this pop-up, to display this pop-up only once per user, you'll have to go to the end of this JS code and define it here, the true. If you mention it true, it will show only once. Now, for example, I did it true, hit save. Now, if I go back to my home page after saving this file, obviously, it will not show me after once. And now if I hit refresh again, as you can see, the pop-up is not showing up, because we added a global session from our JS code, which is saved here, pop-up shown, right? Application, so if you open the inspect tools and application, we have this pop-up shown here, true. We can delete this for now because I want to show you guys about this pop-up. Okay, now define false again and hit save. Okay, hit refresh. There we go. Our pop-up is showing up again. That's it for the tutorial, guys. You will find all of the codes in YouTube video description, and you can add this customized pop-up to your store without using any app. You can add images to this pop-up. I already added the newsletter form, which is same as the bottom here. So it's the default Dawn theme newsletter form, which will add customer to your store. I hope you guys liked it. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below. Until next video, have a great day.